Well, let's go across to some of our guests now. Mayuresh Joshi of Angel Broking is with us. Sudarshan Sukhani has been speaking to us as well. Mayuresh, hi, afternoon. One of the stocks of the day clearly is SpiceJet, up 11% post its numbers. But at this juncture, does it make sense to take a fresh position on SpiceJet if you haven't capitalized on it already?
Afternoon, Sonia. I think it's a very tough call to take at this point of time. And going by numbers, I think over the past few quarters, SpiceJet has given a huge amount of resilience when it comes to the profitability. On top of that, I think with ATF prices expected to stay low, I think the input costs for SpiceJet are going to stay low, as for the entire aviation sector as a whole. Clearly, I think with the number of flights getting increased, you're probably looking at utilization levels going up, the load factors increasing. You're probably looking at the ancillary share of income probably edging up as well from the higher single digits to double digits. And you're also probably looking at induction of new planes, which might be the 737 MAX planes or narrow bodied planes. And if that fleet size probably goes up, you're probably looking at even greater amount of sharing agreements probably taking place and more routes being captured. So clearly, I think it is gaining market share. The numbers are testimony to the fact that with the fall in ATF prices, the profitability has improved tremendously. But again, I think it'll be a brave man at this juncture, looking at the kind of rise that you've probably seen in the price, to probably take a huge call on the stock. So at the current juncture, I think it's just a wait and watch for us. I think it's been a huge moment onto the stock. But clearly, I think if crude prices stay the way they are, if you really expect the occupancy levels to maintain itself, assuming that a lot of the rail traffic probably comes to the air traffic, clearly SpiceJet will be a big beneficiary. You're probably seeing signs of turnaround happening in the results that have been witnessed so far.
Okay, Mayuresh, hi, good afternoon. But what about the Indigo now? I mean, at 1,000, 1,100, there was a mad rush to buy, and at 900 now, we have the genuine risk of stock going to its listing price, not the issue price, but at least the listing price.
So clearly, Anuj, I think if people would have invested in the stock in the IPO, I think you're still making money on this stock. To top that up, I think there were issues raised, possibly in terms of how the numbers have been displayed by the management and some links related to how corporate governance issues are probably cropping up. Having said that, probably, I think the late delivery of A320neos has something which has affected the operating expenses for this airline. But clearly, I think if you probably look at how the ATF prices are behaving generally for the aviation sector as a whole, I think Indigo should be a clear beneficiary as well. Top that up, I think, look at their fleet size, it's one of the youngest. So clearly, I think there are a lot of attributes that are probably working in its favor. But clearly, I think what has not gone well with the street and a lot of analysts is the way they're probably disclosed. So I think the performance of Indigo, which is probably witnessed on the screens, and the outperformance of SpiceJet, I think it's testimony to the fact of what both these companies have probably reported.
Okay, I have many more questions for you to do with earnings, but we need to take a short break. So we'll come back and chat some more. The market is still where it was, so up just 0.2%. But on the other side, our Srishankar of Prabhudas Lilladhar will join in to give us some of his top mid-cap picks post the earnings season.
It's extremely difficult to assess the bottom here, given the number of moving parts and the number of factors that could change literally minute by minute. So to that extent, I won't second guess where the market is going. What would be a useful assessment is how have prices behaved, how have valuations behaved, given the changes in earnings estimates that you'd have to make. To that extent, yes, the market is relatively more attractive than it was, say, a couple of months ago.
Welcome back to the show. As promised, we're going to discuss a lot of stocks and numbers that have come out as well with our next guest, R. Srishankar of Prabhudas Lilladhar. He's the head of institutional equities there. Srishankar, hi, afternoon, and thanks for joining us. I was just going through some of your top mid-cap picks recommendations, and you have a good day and a good week. That's the word coming in from Prabhudas Lilladhar. But, you know, Subros has just announced their numbers, and that's another auto ancillary that has been a big gainer lately. We should get the numbers up for you on the screen. The total income has grown to 328 crores versus 281 crores, so that's looking quite good for Subros, and that stock has spiked up about more than 4% odd. Good growth coming in on the top line, and on the bottom line it's also a doubling of profits to 6 crores versus 3.8 crores, so almost a doubling of profits, and that is taken well by the street. 6.5% higher now for Subros. As we know, Subros makes air conditioners for a lot of auto companies like Maruti, etc. So that is looking quite good. We'll wait by for the operational performance, but there you have it, 8% higher now on Subros. Top line and bottom line have grown very well. When some of its clients like Maruti are growing at such a fast pace, then it's just a given that companies like Subros will also be growing in tandem. 10% higher now on that particular company. 9 months also, the numbers are looking very good. So 946 crores in terms of revenues for 9 months versus 890 crores earlier. And the profits in 9 months are also looking good, 16 crores versus 12.8. crores. We'll do one thing, we'll try and touch base with the management, and we will also tell you our closing bell money control question of the day, which is SpiceJet. That company has soared after reporting a fourth consecutive quarter of profits. Do you see more money moving out of Interglobe and into SpiceJet? Just log on to moneycontrol.com, post your responses there, and we'll read out some of the interesting responses post 3:30.
Renault Passion for Life presents Headlines of the Day. Brought to you by Renault Passion for Life.
Welcome back. Well, the market is stable after a long time on a Monday. So, time for us to get back to our Monday special, Midcap Mania, with Nigel D'Souza. And the stock on his radar is a company that's one of the largest manufacturers of electricity meters in India. And the stock has gained 66% in the last 2 months. Nigel?
Well, Anuj, the stock that we're talking about is in fact Genius Power. The stock has been moving quite well. So just run you through a quick background check of what exactly the company does currently. They operate in three verticals, so that in fact should come up for you. We should see exactly what do they do. They work. They operate in metering solution division. That's the main one. Besides that, they do some engineering construction as well as power backup system. So that's really what the company does currently. Now, there is potential in terms of their meter business, because smart meters is something that they produce. And in fact, demand growth in smart meters is something that could drive the stock. And the government has been talking about advanced metering systems as well. That's another big driver. Just last year, the government of India had announced that in fact they are looking to strengthen distribution system. So that in fact could be a big trigger for the stock going ahead as well. Now, this may result in nearly around 130 million meters, smart meters going ahead. So there is potential for this company going ahead, because they do produce smart meters. Now, the big clients are up for you on the screen. We have NTPC, Tata Power, CESC, Reliance Industries, even quite a few SCBs as well are some of their clients. So they've got a good amount of clients as well. As you mentioned, let's focus then on other aspects of the company. We did see that, in fact, the stock did move very well, 66% just in the last couple of months. And in fact, the stock hit a 52-week high on 12 January 2016. From there, it's corrected close to around 10%. So we're looking to buy stocks on dips. This is just one of those potential candidates given its fundamentals. Now, if you just take a look at the shareholding pattern, the promoter holds nearly around 50% stake. This entity is in fact a trustee of the company, while we have a big investor there, Vala Bansali. He's been holding around 1.2% stake for a long period as well. So watch out, we have an influential investor in this company. If you take a look at the financials as well, that as well should come up for you on the screen. The first half of the year, we have seen a good growth on the top line. Margins as well have expanded, and profitability as well has gone up. So at the halfway mark, they've done nearly around 2 rupees in terms of EPS for the full year. If you just extrapolate that, it should come to close to around 4 rupees per share. So at 60 rupees, it's still not very very cheap, because it's trading at more than 15 times as well, given the current market price. Then moving on, if you just go to look at it, in fact, we'll see that the current order book is nearly around 470 crores roughly, and they have the Haridwar plant, which can give them tax advantages for the next few years. So that as well is fairly important. The weak financial health of the SCBs, that's something that doesn't work in that in their favor, and they have close to around 160 days of receivables in FY15, but that has come down from around 225. So those are a mix of the positives as well as the negatives. Interesting stock going ahead, given the trigger with regard to smart meters. Back to you.
All right, Nigel, thanks for that. We'll keep that on our radar. But now let's go across to Nuresh Mirani, who's going to tell you what to buy or sell today for a reverse trade tomorrow. Nuresh, over to you.
Yeah, the first recommendation is to buy an ICICI Bank with a target price of 248 and a stop loss at 230. And the second one is a buy on Reliance Capital, the target price of 390 and the stop loss at 360.
All right, Naresh, thanks a lot for those trading ideas. Well, we've been talking to Naresh Joshi of Angel Broking and also Sudarshan Sukhani on the technicals. Sudarshan, a word on some of these big movers today, whether it's Larsen & Toubro, Tata Motors, Hero MotoCorp. Some of these index heavyweights have seen quite a bit of selling in, you know, last 2 or 3 hours of trade today.
Well, Larsen & Toubro and Tata Motors are in sustained downtrends, so it's not surprising. Hero MotoCorp, I would like to think, is an exception. If the market remains stable and cheerful as it is now, the stock should go up eventually, with whatever little rally it does, but that decline is not to be sold into. For Tata Motors and for L&T, every small rally is a selling opportunity.
Okay. Mayuresh, I know you track MRF closely. You know, the revenues of that company continue to disappoint. In fact, 3% lower now for the revenues because of the demand slumping and the Chinese tires getting dumped. What do you do with the stock at this price?
So clearly, Sonia, even if you go by the past quarter's result and the management transcript thereof, I think the management was very, very clear. They're facing double issues. A, as you rightly pointed out, I think the Chinese imports are causing huge amount of concerns for the tire industry in general. Add to that, I think the OEM sales have probably dwindled down a little bit. Again, I think the margins were a tad bit disappointing because if one really assumes that the pass-through has happened because of the lower raw material costs, they're probably not getting in margins as justification because I think the margins were at around 23.3 in the quarter gone by, which have clearly come down. So I think even if in a scenario of lower crude prices, lower natural and synthetic rubber prices, you're probably looking at margins sustained between these 21 and 22% range. So clearly what has affected them is these conditions going forward. They will still keep on affecting them. So clearly we've kept a very tepid growth angle in terms of how the top line will grow over the next 2 years. And the valuations might be supportive at this point. I think the management commentary will be key at this juncture. So clearly at this point of time, I think understanding the management commentary, the business outlook, and generally I think the tire industry's dynamics going forward is something to be keenly watched out for.
Okay, Deepak Shenoy is also with us. Let's see if he has a call on MRF as well. Deepak, good afternoon. Have you seen the numbers from MRF prima facie, and do you have a call on the stock?
Afternoon, Anuj. I took a look at the numbers actually. I mean, MRF, I think I've done a 3%
profit. Deepak, I'll come back to you.
More than 4,000.
Deepak, I'll come back to you. We just need to sort out that audio issue. There's some problem with that. Let's do one thing. We'll repatch that audio line. For now, let's go close to Varinder for Buzzing Stocks.
Well, it's the results there, and I'll start with some of the results which are, you know, which are making stocks buzz in the green. SpiceJet, Force Motors, Tour One Retail, Indiabulls Wholesale, Coromandel Engineering, Supreme Petro. Results which are reacting on the negative side: RS Software, Intellect Design, Kitex, Lumix Auto Technologies. Some other small cap gainers like Akshar Chemicals, Cantabil up 20%, Manglam Timbers up 20% for second day running, Gayatri Starchem, Daiichi Karkaria, that stock has been gaining since last few days, Excel Info, Pony Sugar, where there's a block deal today, Kothari Products, Flat Product Equipment, Ashok Elko, Barak Valley Cements, Anar Industries, Sunstar Reality, Kamanwala Housing, Bhagiratha Chemicals, Raj TV, again that stock has been moving since last few days, Visagra Poly, Nitin Fire, RDB Industries, Lumex Auto, Duke Offshore. There are some notable mid-cap gainers as well today. Look at Sequent Scientific, that stock is up 10%. Kaplan Point, again that stock has gained nearly 15-17% in the last 2 days. Valchand Nagar up 6-7% last time I checked. Jandu Reality, Group Finance is moving up today. Waterbase and Alpha Geo as well. Keep an eye on few stocks which where the results will be reported on Wednesday, that is after 1 day holiday. HDFC Limited of course, but United Spirits, Just Dial, Havells, SKS, these are stocks which are very volatile and has come off from days high. Other companies like Bharat Electronics Limited, Bharti Infratel, IDFC Bank will be important numbers to watch out for when we open for trade on Wednesday.
Okay, Vander, thanks for that. Well, we just have about 8 minutes left to close, and today will be an okay sort of a day. So 0.2% higher, but today confirms one thing, that the bulls are not out of danger just yet, and that there could be a lot of volatility in the wings as well, given what we've seen across the global market. So as we speak, the Dow futures are down 0.3%. The European markets are in the red as well. It's not done with the pain. But let's get back to stocks now. Mayuresh Joshi was telling us about some of the stocks that he recommends. Mayuresh, from the earnings season so far, which has been your top mid-cap performer and a stock in which you can put fresh money into now?
So clearly, I think LIC Housing, Sonia, is something that has impressed us in terms of both the earnings trajectory as well as the asset quality. Clearly, if you look at the cost to income ratios, if you look at the asset quality trend going forward, our own take is that the earnings growth should be in excess of 20%. On top of that, I think if you're talking about retail advances, which form a major part of their earnings profile, I think that is expected to grow at a decent pace as well. On a price to book basis, I think it trades around 2.2, 2.3 times, which I believe is very, very reasonable. So LIC Housing Finance is something that we continue to like within the mid-cap space out of the numbers that have probably come. So
okay, Sudarshan, is there enough trading history for you to take a call on Interglobe, or would you say that maybe this is avoided for now?
No, it's best avoided for now, although IPOs which rally in the way it did and then start falling seldom go back to their original levels quickly. So in that sense, it is not a buying opportunity, that much I'm sure.
Oh yes, you know, in fact, a lot of people forget that Jet is not back to its previous prices. It's IPO price. Yeah. It's what, double, trebled, or whatever in last 1 year. But even that's not back to its previous IPO price.
Oh yes, indeed. Sudarshan, pardon me if you don't track this stock, but you know, it's been on my list post its numbers. Subros, that one is up almost about 14% now. And if I'm not mistaken, it's actually had a very good run in the last 1 year. Any thoughts on that name?
Oh yes, it's had a dream run from 40 to almost 115. It's also not exactly, but almost at 52-week highs. And the corrections in Subros has been very tepid. So it's been certainly outperforming the ancillary sector and also outperforming the Nifty. So with all this background, I think the stock is a buying opportunity. If you are looking for building a mid-cap portfolio, it's a very good idea.
Okay, it's a very good idea. That Subros, the numbers looked really good and the stock is up about close to 11%. Mayuresh, what about something like an IDBI Bank, which has corrected 40% now? Okay, Mayuresh is not with us for now. Sudarshan, you want to take that IDBI Bank?
Yeah, I want to take that. I don't even understand why we want to buy that stock. I mean, you could buy State Bank with the please avoid it. There's nothing in it. It's on the verge of a significant breakdown. You know, that was rumored. And that rumor is out with. All the gains of that rumor have been finished. If you look at the weekly chart, it's on the verge of a significant breakdown. Stay away from it.
And I remember at that time when the rumor was at its peak, at that time also you had said that just be aware of this chart, you know, beware a little bit. So now we know why that was. Mayuresh is back with us. Mayuresh, IDBI Bank, Anuj was asking you about, that stock has come off considerably in the last couple of months. How do you approach it?
No, clearly, Sonia, I think the stock moved up in expectations of moving on similar lines of what an Axis Bank has done. But has the core performance indicated that? I probably don't think so. So clearly, if you look at how the asset quality has panned out for the bank over the past so many quarters, I think they're still going through painful and stressful times. And our belief is that this should continue at least for the next 2 to 3 quarters, to say the least. So it's wishful thinking on one part to probably have the same being run in the way Axis Bank is getting run. But it also took a long time for Axis Bank to be where it is at this current juncture. So clearly, the markets are realigning themselves to the fact that everything might move out in that way over the next few years. But clearly at this juncture, I think the asset quality pressures would continue on the balance sheet of IDBI Bank. So clearly, I think the stock is probably reacting in terms of how the numbers might probably pan out for the bank over the next few quarters.
Okay, just about 3.5 minutes left. So let's just squeeze in one last question. Sudarshan, is Reliance repeating the same story? Every time it looks like it's set to take over leadership, we see post results this big decline. Already 10% off highs at current levels. What's the call?
No, but the Nifty has also fallen. My call is that Reliance is a must in every portfolio. You know, I remember comparing it to Hind Unilever, and Hind Unilever had the same story for 10 years, and then it multiplied and became 4 times, 5 times. You have to be patient. It's a very large cap stock, but I don't think it's going in a bad. It's not going to underperform the Nifty. It's going to outperform.
Okay, let's do one thing. Just about 3 minutes left for markets to close. So let's do a quick recap. It was a decent day, but a day in which the bears may want to believe that they had the upper hand, especially if they would have shorted intraday or first thing in the morning, because the market gave 2 dips today and closed much of the high point of the day. Let's talk about the stocks that led the market on the way up, because it's still going to be a green day, and in that you have to look at ICICI Bank. as the top contributor, up 1.5%. HDFC as well was up 1.5%, and HDFC Bank was up about close to 1%. ITC and Infosys were two other stocks where we saw some gains. Apart from that, Cairn India was of course your top gainer, that was up 5%, reacting more to the recent moves in crude rather than its quarterly earnings. Tata Steel was up about 3%. Sun Pharma, in fact, it's been a strong 2 days for Sun Pharma now, 2% higher in today's trade. Ambuja, Coal India, Hindustan, other big gainers in trade today. What was taking the market lower or capping the gains? Larsen & Toubro. That stock was down 3%. Tata Motors as well was down about 2%. For Tata Motors also, it's been a swift correction back from its short covering bounce. State Bank was down about 1%. Maruti lost down today, down 0.5%. Axis Bank was down about close to 1%. Then you had some losers like Mahindra & Mahindra, Adani Port and SEZ. GAIL was down close to 3%, and Zee Entertainment was down about 1%. So all in all, a mixed day as far as large caps are concerned, and maybe a mixed day for mid cap, but more gainers than losers in today.
Well, yes, more gainers than losers, so that's a good thing. But the mid cap index also lost a lot of steam. So yes, you get a sense that there's a little bit of apprehension on the upside. Nobody wants to keep their positions open. Everyone wants to take whatever little gains they have and go home before the holiday tomorrow. In terms of individual stocks, so there were some stocks of the day. SpiceJet was definitely one of them, post a stellar set of numbers. And Interglobe was also one of the stocks of the day on the downside that saw a cut of almost 7%. So clearly, there's a pair trade where money is moving out of Interglobe and into SpiceJet. Subro's delivered a very good set of numbers, so that stock was in the green. Force Motors, Supreme Petrochemical, good numbers coming in there. Those stocks also rallied quite a bit. In terms of some stocks on the downside, you had Kitex Garments. You know, that stock was one of the biggest gainers in the last bull run, and now that stock has halved in just 3-4 months. It's gone from 1,000 to 480, and today that stock tanked 11.5% post its numbers. So some mid-caps are really taking it on the chin. Intellect Design Arena is another one, down about 5-odd%. Relcom fell about 2-odd% or so, and a couple of other names like Nagarjan Construction, etc., were down about 3%. JSW Steel, as you can see, is sitting at a fresh 52-week high, so it's in a complete opposite direction of all the other metal stocks. That stock, in fact, has been moving on the upside. So we have about 9 more seconds to go, and ahead of the Republic Day holiday tomorrow, you get a sense that the bulls don't have it in control just yet. In fact, the bears have made sure that they got the upper hand today. So all the gains were wiped out by the end of trade, and we will close flat, at best, just about a 0.2% gain. But we have a holiday tomorrow, Sudarshan, so there's a bit of a breather for both the bulls and the bears. Who do you think will emerge triumphant on Wednesday?
No, I don't know about Wednesday, pretty frankly. I'm assuming the bulls have some a minor edge. I know in the next one month, the bears will emerge stronger. That is much easier to suggest.
Okay, and which stocks then would you recommend shorting, Sudarshan, from a month's point of view?
Oh, again, you know, the banks, whenever this rally finishes, the banks will come down again. The real estate stocks, metals have not completed their correction, although it appears that they have, and the capital goods. And I think that pharma is going to correct also. Primarily, this will be an across-the-board correction. I mean, the 7,240 is likely to be under test and broken at some point.
Okay. Mayuresh, do you concur with Sudarshan's view that this is just a short-term rally or a pop that we're seeing, and eventually the market will head downwards?
So clearly, Sonia, I think the softness in the markets is expected to continue primarily because of what the global uncertainties will pan out. So clearly, you're not really sure on how crude is going to behave over the next few weeks. You're probably not even sure in terms of how Chinese data points might actually come through. So clearly, I think these two key factors on the global side will keep a huge overhang onto the Indian markets. And earnings have been quite reasonable so far. I think the second half of the earnings, when it comes to PSU banks, when it comes to metals, I think these are the earnings that the market will be watching out for. Again, expectations are pretty muted when these companies will start posting the numbers, which will effectively drag down the overall earnings scenario for Q3. So clearly, I think the earnings trajectory, and then over the next few weeks, what happens with the budget, I think this is something that the markets will like to watch out for. But clearly, I think the softness in the markets would continue, in my opinion.
Okay, softness is going to continue. That's the call from Mayuresh. Mahitesh, what about Cairn? That was the top gainer today. How would you approach the stock?
Well, clearly, Anuj, I think the numbers were expected to be what they are. So clearly, in terms of realizations both on the crude front as well as expectations in terms of how the capex spends will be cut down was one of the obvious things that Cairn would have posted. Again, I think the overhang on the stock, the markets are very well aware of that, whether that be the tax dispute that is going on, what happens probably in terms of the merger ratio with Vedanta. So clearly, I think I've always maintained that with the kind of cash that Cairn has on its books, around $2.7 billion, I think the cash per share is almost equivalent to more than two-thirds of the price that Cairn is currently quoting at. So clearly, I think what happens with the production sharing contract and all the other issues that the markets are aware of, the markets are probably giving a little amount of weightage on the other side apart from cash. So clearly, I think the dividend deal, the cash is largely being ignored by the markets, but it is for obvious reasons. I think if you expect crude to stay in the range of what really one expects over the next few quarters and years, you're probably looking at Cairn's realization actually coming down, which effectively means that the cash flows that one really expects from Cairn, I think they should start building down, which will effectively mean that the dividend yields will start coming down. So clearly, I think the markets will give all these facts into cognizance, and clearly for these factors, I think Cairn might underperform over the medium term.
Okay, and finally, before we let you go, Sudarshan, any individual stock ideas that you'd want to recommend for Wednesday's trade?
Wednesday is difficult because if we are 2 days away, but I would stay with the large caps. Then the large caps IT stocks are probably the easiest to buy if we come into Wednesday, and the oil and gas group, GAIL, then Reliance, IG Gas, Indraprastha Gas. These are the two sectors, IT and oil gas. I would not take any stock in the morning beyond these two sectors. That, let me quickly tell you that Cairn came with an IPO price of 160 rupees in 2006. Now we are in 2016 and the price is 118. So much wealth destruction.
Clearly, and in between it saw 450, 460 as well. So from that point, the wealth destruction has been even more, Sudarshan. Thanks a lot for your time today and talking to us. Mahesh, thanks to you as well. We'll take a break on that note, but our closing bell money control question of the day is clearly on the sector of the day. SpiceJet rose after reporting fourth consecutive quarter of profit. Do you see more money moving out of Interglobe and into SpiceJet? Well, we'll read out some of the most interesting responses posted on moneycontrol.com on the other side.